What up, y'all? This is your boy Jerry Speaks. If you guys are new to the channel, make sure you guys smash that like button, smash the subscribe button, and smash the like and subscribe buttons of my boys, Miller Boy and Heems Gaming. You know, for live streaming, they do some pretty dope stuff. You might even catch your boy up on there kicking some ass alongside them. All right, let's get into the episode tonight. Cloak and Dagger season 2, episode 5 already. Damn, alignment chart. And wow, this episode really hit a lot of good points. Again, one of the biggest themes they talked about the season is their hidden, you know, human trafficking, you know, drug use and all these, and gang violence and things of that nature. And they're really hitting it home with the human trafficking. I think it's a great thing that they're doing. And in this episode, we see a lot of that. This episode starts out, you know, Tandy and Tyrone once again having the odds, coming to odds with the fact that Connors is out now. You know, Tyrone was pissed because the killer that killed his brother, Billy, you know, was free and loose. He could be doing anything now. But come to find out, actually, after Connors being in that humble void, is what I'll call it, he just came to realize, like, you know, I need to make peace with this. I need to make justice. Justice needs to be served. You know, as he told Tyrone, he's like, look, man, when I was in there, man, I kept hearing every thought that I made, everything that I've done, all my own voice. It just drove him crazy. And so that's what drove Connors into just giving, having, and just turning himself into Tyrone, you know, throwing himself at the mercy of his court, you know, his family's court, you know, his father seeing him first, almost stabbing his damn eye out. Excuse me, amongst almost wanting to do other things as well. Excuse me, then his own brother, and then his own mother seeing him as well at the very end of the episode, and as well as Tandy, you know, taking on human trafficking in a whole other way. She said, look, I'm doing this for you, Leah, because, why, Leah, because you've been through a lot. And I didn't know that Leah was a former prostitute, but, you know, and one of the and things of that nature. But, you know, Tandy took it to a lot of weed growers at the time and human traffickers at the time. People, at least the people that are responsible for it. After Leela told him, which I think is a bit of a setup on her end, it was like she was still in cahoots with her ex-boyfriend, you know, and still helping him out unbeknownst to her current boyfriend, Andre. You know, maybe Andre doesn't know that Leela is doing this still, or maybe he does know, but, you know, he's just going along with it, you know. Maybe, you know, Andre going up to Tandy was how he kind of recruits people. That's what I'm thinking. I think maybe that's how their human trafficking group works. Andre being, you know, playing to their emotions, you know, getting close with them, then all of a sudden they bring them to the group, you know, Leela gets their names, and they go into their little trafficking spot. But, you know, see Tandy take the whoop ass to him, and then having her tell her mother straight up, like, look, you know, a man having all this money and giving you all these that you want is one thing, but the moment he decides to beat on you and things like that, is that you don't stick around for that. You just leave. That's not love. You just leave. Plain and simple. So when, now that Tandy, you know, she went to Leela for help, you know, trying to mend things between her and Tyrone. Tyrone was looking for her anyway to help her out with Connors, finding Connors at first, but then he finds him, as I mentioned, you know. He went through family court with Tyrone's family and things of that nature. But, you know, then Tyrone walks away from her because he kind of felt like he was just being coerced, you know, and Tandy pretty much lied and tricked him into doing whatever, helping her out, but he did all right on his own. But then Tandy was the one who actually got fucked over, and she got screwed over, as she told Tyrone in the very beginning of the episode. So I wonder how next week's gonna go. I'm pretty sure everything will be all right. But throughout the episode, you know, you can see Bridget get her stuff back. You know, she gets her mojo back. She gets all of her stuff right. So I'm really happy to see that too. She was at the gun range getting distracted, things of that nature. You know, looking at her former boyfriend Kenneth Fuchs. You know, his mug, his obituary, that motivated her, that put the spark back in her to do what she has to do as a cop and as a person. So I'm really glad for that. But then also, you know, throughout the episode, we see a narration to Tandy about the home between about the farmer and the viper. You know, she talked about how everyone might interpret, you know, the poem, you know, between the farmer and the viper. The farmer being the good guy, the viper being, you know, the bad guy, and how pretty much you can't change the nature of someone. But that's not always true, because the viper's always going to be the viper, you know. And lo and behold, I mean, that's what happens. But let me know what you guys think, man, in the comments below. Did you guys enjoy this episode? What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. You're always welcome. As always, will be. Peace and love.